been known to do at times and keep her emotions in check. And also, she has to do something offensively. Only 2 points in her two meetings versus Emery Riddle last year. Has to be a big force offensively, especially if Stone and Harrison can't get going on the offensive end.
A veteran Cruz, Xiomara Cruz, our friend, is the lead official with Whitney Dunlap and Tashiana Smith toting the whistles for the Sunshine State Conference. In the blue with gold numerals and trim, Embry Riddle from, I guess, about 55 miles up I-4 here in Daytona Beach. Tars in the white, blue numerals, blue and gold trim. Two undefeated top 20 teams matching up here at the Alphonse Sports Center. The tip is taken, tipped and controlled by the Rollins Stars. Here's Vernicia Andrews. We'll bring it into the front court against the woman-to-woman. Hands to Daniels. Double D. Jalen Harrison backing up. Throws it a little too long, but the rebound will come down to Jasmine Stone. Tars get a second possession here. Top of the key. Working the perimeter. Looking for Daniels inside. Now they get it to her. Denise turning, popping off the iron. And away comes Embry Riddle. Ellenberger in a hurry. From Granger, Indiana, Tars will open woman-to-woman with Harrison on Ellenberger. Now Fields with McClendon on her. And a nice defensive play by Carly forces the Fields miss. They're going to go right after McClendon.
They're going to, especially, and Carly has to do make sure she stays vertical, stays upright, and don't lean anything to her body that can give these officials a chance to blow the whistle and get a quick foul.
Just beating the five-second count there and almost throwing that ball away. You can't throw a lazy pass against Embry Riddle. They will jump the passing lanes with eight to shoot. Crossover move by Harrison around to McClendon screen. Takes it all the way in, loses the handle, got to throw it up, and will not. Daniels had no idea what the shot clock was saying. So the Tars, probably at the top of the league in shot clock violations, get one here.
And really, Robert, we kind of mentioned this Saturday versus Caldwell, the inability of anybody on the court, on the bench, to let them know, hey, you got a shot clock running down, just throw it up and see what happens.
Exactly. Maybe draw iron, maybe get an offensive board. Here's Fields backing in on McClendon and misses the shot. Carly gets the rebound, and they kick it up to Andrews. Andrews will lose the handle. Andrews out of control, could not make the pass. Turnover by the Tars, scoreless. A minute 40 into this one. Ellenberger will work it out high to the Swedish sophomore Sandstrom. Whiting, outstanding player, and got a lucky break there, throwing it baseline, and it got into the hands of Sandstrom. Now here's the pass over on the side.
3 seconds called on Fields.
3 second call, yeah.
Trying to get position on McClendon on the left block, and Tara kind of not realizing what the clock is in her head, and an easy 3 second violation called by Xiomara Cruz.
Both teams have missed each of their two shots here, and Daniels will bring it up across the line. Daniels out of McClendon. No threat out there, but Fields is playing a very, very tight. Jasmine Stone now will take it all the way in and got hammered. Nice move, Jasmine. Attack that attacking defense. And Jasmine can do it with the best of them. I have a chance to give the Tars the early lead as the foul whistled on Tucker.
And Rollins is early on trying to cut and slash and realizing that McClendon is going to have a tough matchup on Fields, trying to get their guards getting flowing in the first few possessions offensively.
And that one's going to get the friendly roll. Jasmine, 2 minutes and 9 seconds into this one, gets the Tars on the board. Shooting just 6 of 13, 7 of 14 now. He's much better free throw shooter than that. 2-0, Rollins. 7:50 remaining, first quarter, Ellenberger. Sabrina Whiting, and they're working that screen down low, and they're trying to get Fields open. Fields now has got it, and she will go to her right and score. He's real strong. She gets McClendon on her hip, and that's trouble for the Tars. There's Andrews, and we're going to have a blocking foul. That'll be whistled down on Sandstrom. Second team foul on the Eagles. Engler is going to replace Andrews in the Rollins lineup.
And here's the interesting thing, Robert. With Andrews being guarded by Sandstrom, they have an opportunity to utilize her athleticism to their advantage. With Engler back on the court now, Sandstrom will have to worry about that three-point shooting from Julia.
McClendon with that one dribble. You can't do that. And that ball was tipped. Carly has a habit of just popping that dribble, and then she's stuck. And here is Denise Daniels taking it all the way in. We'll bank it off the iron. No good. McClendon tried to tip it. Can't do it.
And I'll call
We're
going to
have a travel in backcourt. What'd they call? Yeah.
They're going to call.
What'd they call?
I think they call it. Did he call a travel? Yep, they call it travel.
Travel. It's Rollins basketball.
Stone thought she was going to get called for the foul, initiating the contact on the back of Ellenberger, and that's what Coach Lisa Nuxall-Wilson is trying to explain. But good job by Jasmine forcing the turnover.
We're almost 3 minutes into this one. Rollins has yet to put one in the hole here, and now they do get the ball inbounds. Jalen Harrison. Top of the key. They're not going to get too many open three-point looks against this team. Now Denise Daniels backing it down, turning, shooting, and we'll get the roll. Really got a good back-to-the-basket game that she's been showing this year. And Daniels now gives Rollins a two-point lead, but they leave Ellenberger all alone. Ellenberger, 42% shooter. Thank you very much. I will give Embry-Riddle the lead. Just a little screen there. You can't go under that screen and give her that open look. Here's Engler. Definitely a much taller Sandstrom on her. But I think Julia's a little bit quicker. Harrison now to Daniels. Jasmine Stone's runner off the mark. Nice rebound, McClendon. Now to Jaylen. Engler throws it on the side. 6 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Looking back door, not there. Daniels will get a bump. And Engler's open, didn't fire it up. She will take it to the hole and
count
get it.
And foul.
Trying to close out on the three-pointer, and Engler with the ball fake went right around Sandstrom, and I believe that's her second, isn't it? With 5:49 remaining, it is.
And a big time blow for Coach Nuxall-Wilson, and she has to go deep into her bench early on. Ashley McWilliams and Marissa Koopman check into the game, especially with Sancho with her two fouls. That's one less partner that Ellenberger and Fields had to take off that scoring load.
Very short lineup for the Rollins Stars. Engler's free throw, it comes up short. Boy, you don't see that too often. She was 7 for 7 coming in. And quickly Fields is up ahead of the pack. Thank you. Lays it in. Gets all of her buckets within about 3 or 4 feet of the rim. And here's Daniels. 7-6 Embry-Riddle lead here early. 5:30 remaining. Andrews back to the basket. Not a threat in there. And Fields will take it away from her. Lucky Blake, I think, yeah, for Rollins as that ball goes off the legs of the Embry-Riddle player who had just checked into the lineup.
Yep, that was McWilliams there in the defense with Fields. And now with McClendon out, they're going to have Fields guard Daniels, so the Tars got to get it done on the perimeter with 10 on the shot clock.
Yeah, they've got that inbound play. Now they get it in. And here goes Engler on the baseline. Her runner is off the mark, and she will charge. There's no question about that one. Into the lineup also for Embry-Riddle, Koopman, and Ashley McWilliams, the senior. 6.5 points per game out of Tampa. Joe Bistro for Rollins is in the lineup, as is the freshman Rachel Jablonski. Midway through the low-scoring quarter, 7-6, Embry-Riddle. Almost a 5-second count, and they get it to Fields.
And they'll call a foul on Daniels trying to hold on Fields. You don't want to let her get too deep in the paint. Trying to let her try and catch it outside the block, maybe force her to make a move.
Are you surprised they're not fronting her?
Well, the way with Fields, the way she moves around without the basketball as we take our media timeout, she does a good job of getting her feet and battling and winning those position battles, trying to get it on the left and right block. And Daniels had nothing to do there, try to hold her, prevent her from staying in the lane, and gets called for that foul. It'll take us to our media timeout. The Rollins College Department of Athletics would like to recognize its contributing partners: Geico, AdPro Team Sports, Coca-Cola, Jewett Orthopedic Clinic, Seminole Chiropractic Medicine, Yorgoland, Hilton Orlando and Altamont Springs, Spectrum Sports Performance, Waterboy Sports, Simple Dot Productions, and Jim Hogue Photography. Thank you for all of your support of Rollins Athletics.
That's Victor Anderson. I'm Robert Siegel. You're listening to Sunshine State Conference Basketball on the brand new Sunshine State Conference digital platform, I guess you would call
platform,
it.
Platform, all on all streaming media, Apple TV, Roku, your Google Chromecast.
There you go. We're going to have the Yogurtland postgame show, and Victor and I will pick the Hilton Orlando at Altamont Springs player of the game. So far, really just a defensive struggle. Embry Riddle 3-for-5, however. Rollins 2-for-6. Embry Riddle did hit their only three-pointer. Rollins missed their only one. 2-for-3 from the line for Rollins. No free throws yet for Embry Riddle. Cars will come out in that zone as they do on the out-of-bounds play on the baseline. Now they throw it down low, and it's tipped around, and we're going to have a jump ball. What do they got?
Yeah. No, it's
kickball. Kickball.
Kickball while Bistro had. Nope, they're going to say it was a kickball before the possession was established.
Yeah, she looked like she was pointing down toward the Embry-Riddle basket, but she did call the kick as Fields will check out of the lineup. And coming in is Morgan Ackerman, the junior from Lake Mary. And we've got a bucket on the inbounds play. Stars were not paying attention. Is that foul on Bistro? No, that's on Bistro. Koopman averaging 3.3. She's 3-for-3 from the line on the year from Germany. And she completes the three-point play. Biggest lead of the game, 10-6, Embry-Riddle. Stars just totally not awake on that inbounds play. They got Daniels on the baseline, but she's not moving. Jablonski now. Bistro's three. Way off the mark. Ball tipped by Bistro, and away comes Daniels. They give it off to Vernice Andrews. Jablonski will lash the three. That's way off the mark. And a rebound put up by Daniels. Nice play. Denise now with four. Cuts the Embry-Riddle lead to two as Ellenberger will drive. Are they going to count that?
Yep. And, and that's Bistro's second.
So for the second time, Rollins, unawake, if you will, asleep at the wheel, coming down court. And Embry-Riddle beating him up court as Daniels will sit, Bistro will sit, Harrison back in, McClendon for Rollins. Ellenberger looking for her 6 point, only averaging 8 a game. And she's got 6 already here. 4:15 remaining. First quarter. Stars down by 5. Biggest lead of the game for the undefeated Eagles. Jablonski. Now we'll give off to Harrison. Oh, Engler's open. And she will back up and knock down a 3. How did that happen? Very slow to get over there was Koopman. Here comes Ellenberger again. And backed off. And now has an open 3-point shooter off the mark. McClendon will corral another rebound. And away come the Tars. Down by 2. Harrison pounds that dribble. And now has it tipped. Nope, they're going to say she lost it out of bounds.
And Harrison thought that she thought they had one, clearly not out of her hands. But
looks like it from here. I don't know what you see.
And really, you have to, when you have somebody with great defensive hands like Ellenberger, as we alluded to, she's top 6 in the conference in steals. You know she's going to have active hands. Get your hands in the passing lane, and Harrison has to be aware of that.
There's Ackerman. Blue-clad Embry-Riddle, 13. Ooh, looked like a traveling move there, but spinning up and missing the shot badly was Koopman. And now Ellenberger will steal it from Andrews. You're going to be loose with that ball. She will steal you blind. And Coach Wilkes over there shaking his head, cannot believe it. Now they throw it on the block, and that shot is up and in. A very slow move by Tucker, but she banks it home out of Marshall, Michigan. And it's a 15-11 lead. Tucker averaging 10.3, nearly 8 boards, having a great freshman year. I don't know where Andrews is going, but she picks up her dribble, and now we'll give it off to Jablonski. Beautiful move by Jablonski. And an assist for Vernicia.
And Engler with the steal inbounds.
Nice steal, tying up that ball game. And Julia Engler putting some points on the board as she did in the last game. Why are they backing off of Ellenberger? Why?
Glenn Wilkes is wondering the same thing. She has 9 quick points in this first quarter.
She's a 42% shooter. How can you back off of her? 18-15. Tars had tied the game very briefly. Here's McClendon. Turning, jumping, hitting. Carly McClendon on the board. That's into a 1-point game.
And a good job by Carly. She caught it with the right. Knowing she's turning with her strong side, the left side. turning with the left hand to finish, and it tars it down by one.
Looking for help. Now throws it to Ellenberger.
Timeout. I think Glenn Wilkes was about to get ready to call a timeout there, but his coaching staff says, let's hold off. I think better of it. Ellenberger, 11 points in his first quarter.
He's just absolutely using Jalen Harrison on defense here as McClendon with that one dribble picking it up. And Engler with the three. I shouldn't say it, but she's hit seven in a row now.
It's Ellenberger and Engler with a mano-a-mano showdown in his first quarter. Nice tip by McClendon on the entry pass.
Engler going around the screen on the baseline. It was a quick trigger that she's got as Tara Fields comes back in. Tara's listed at 6 feet. Wears her hair up. Looks about 6'4" inside. Now they're looking for Fields. McClendon on her with 1:10 remaining. Fields in the lane. They can't get it to her. Whiting is back in for Embry-Riddle. She's got the ball. Now Fields. Cars are in a zone. Looking high-low.
And a travel.
A little traveling music for Nicole Tucker that time. And the Tars now with a chance to take back the lead with under a minute remaining. First quarter. Daniels slowly up court. 10 points already in this game for Engler. As McClendon now will throw it over. And Engler again for 8 in a row. My goodness gracious alive.
And she's now second all time in program history in three-pointers with 3 of them in this first quarter.
Here's Ellenberger around the screen, but this time Harrison's got her. Fields, 12-footer off the mark. Oh, that ball was tipped out of bounds by Fields. McClendon, that ball took an extra bounce on the rim there.
Yep.
And now the shot clock is off with 26.9 seconds remaining. The Tars with a 3-point lead and the basketball. We were really slowly scoring 7-6 after 5 minutes.
And then all of a sudden, everybody starts to wake up.
Boom. Ellenberger and this lady, Engler. And here's Engler banking. Oh, just couldn't get it to go. Took a quick shot. And now Embry-Riddle will have a chance to hold if they want to. And Fields 15 feet out off the mark. And Fields will battle, and that's going to be over the back, I think,
yep,
on Fields.
Over the back on Fields. Now, that's the 5th foul, but since it was on the offensive end for Embry-Riddle, no foul shot for the Tars. 5 seconds left, and they're going to try to get it to Harrison's hands.
4th foul. That was just the 4th.
4th foul.
Yeah, that would have been a shooting foul. Here's Jalen Harrison. Got to shoot it, Jalen. She's going to fire it up. And comes up short, but a good effort by Harrison, who finished the first quarter scoreless. And Rollins comes back from a 5-point deficit to take a 3-point lead in this one. I'm kind of surprised at all that scoring in the second 5 minutes of the quarter.
Wait a minute. These are the same two teams that are, like, giving up less than 57 points per game, and we're on pace for an 87-84 game. Just shows you, ladies and gentlemen, when basketball happens, you never know what's going to happen on the court.
Yeah, well, that's the great thing about college basketball. You do know that Julia Engler can shoot three-pointers, and she has right now, I think she's moved past Pranger.
Yep, she's now second all-time in threes. Only Jill Razor left on her sights for the three-point marksman list.
Great career. She's hit 8 in a row. I really shouldn't say that. That may be a record here as Julia Engler was left wide open a couple of times and knocked down a couple of threes. She now has 937 career points, headed for 1,000. And what an outstanding career she has had here at Rollins. So a back and forth first quarter of action. The only negative on the foul side were those two quick fouls that were picked up by Sigrid Sandstrom. And also, for the Rollins Tars, Bernicia Andrews picked up 2. Oh, check that. Joe Bistro had picked up 2 fouls. Here we go in the blue with gold numerals and trim. Going right to left. Tars open in a zone as Whiting, who was scoreless in the first quarter.
And an offensive foul on Fields. That's going to be her second.
Wow. Now that one hurts as Coach Lisa Nuxall-Wilson out of Lake Howell High School here in Seminole County. Went to UCF. Looks down her bench. Now McClendon in the corner. Fields on her. Would love to get in. She picks up her dribble and almost throws it away. Here's Stone. Oh, misses the shot.
A little bit too strong. She had more time than she thought, Robert, and there's maybe anticipating some contact on that drive in the middle.
As Whiting tries to take it in, Stone can get in that lane just about any time. Finishing is a little different. Here's Whiting's 17-footer, and it will not go. Fields, boy,
very
that
unfortunate.
Was...
unfortunate she didn't get whistled for that third.
Yeah,
so
what happened to Harrison there? She picked up the ball and lost the handle. She was headed up court, but the ball was not. And now, 9:05 remaining. Tars up by three. Scoreless second quarter. Jablonski losing the ball. You just can't do that. You can't hold that ball out in front of you like that. They will steal it. Here comes Whiting. Somebody's got to stop her, and they don't.
I mean, literally uncontested. Nobody there to guard her. And she says, hey, I'll take it.
Wow.
I wish the Wayne's were I-4 were that wide open and the lane Whiting had to drive.
And here is Jasmine Stone losing the handle.
Out of bounds, and almost a great play on the out of bounds, on the play by Whiting, trying to throw it off Jablonski.
Ellenberger back in.
And Jessica Savage.
They got to take Fields out with those two fouls. Also, Tucker will head to the bench. Tars have got to inbound the basketball. They need help. And just do get it in. Jablonski, the freshman. Oh, man. Got to be careful with those passes. Here's Daniels skipping it over. And Stone unleashes a three. That'll be off the mark. Bernicia Andrews is going to what? They're going to call it on Bernicia?
Over
what?
It back on Andrews. Trying to battle for the ball with Ellenberger. And that's for Andrews first.
First team foul on the Rollins Tars. 8:20 remaining. Tars are scoreless after finishing that quarter with a flourish. Rollins now in the woman-to-woman defense. They throw it to Ellenberger. Has it tipped away. But it goes right back into the hands of Embry Riddle. Whiting on the perimeter. That goes around Jasmine Stone. Kicks it over on the side with 8 to shoot. And banking it off the mark. Daniels. And we're going to have a jump ball. That'll be Rollins basketball.
They had briefly on the right, or right underneath the basket, Koopman. If she finds her, she has an easy layup, but they instead try to hand in to Savage in traffic. Great triple team by the Tars to get the possession on the jump ball.
Jessica Savage, a 5'9 soft from Brighton, Michigan, is in the ballgame. And with 7:50 remaining, second quarter, only one bucket, and that's a two-pointer by Embry Riddle to cut that lead to one. Skip pass over to Jablonski. She'll stop and pop, and it won't go. Nice rebound by Andrews, though. Tars get another possession. And Jablonski will try again. This time it's an air ball. Into the ballgame for Rollins. Summer Conti has checked in. As Embry Riddle now in the blue, going right to left. Woman-to-woman defense. Ball fake out high. And back to Ellenberger. Conti will guard her. Conti is just a freshman out of Louisville, Kentucky. 9 to shoot, and Ellenberger goes around Conti, but misses the shot, and a reach-in foul after a nice rebound by Jablonski.
And a good job by Summer Conti. She stuck the left hand in, and that forced Ellenberger enough to alter her shot and get it high off the glass. And we'll see Jablonski come back out, and Engler come on with her.
Oh, wow. What are you doing? Bernicia Andrews just gives the ball away on the inbounds pass. And Ellenberger lays it in to give Embry Riddle the lead. Oh, my goodness. And now Bernicia will throw it away. Having a tough game. Just dribbling into trouble and throwing a pass out. And away comes Embry Riddle. Tars still scoreless. 3 minutes to 20. Bernicia's turning her head on defense. Ellenberger had picked up her dribble, however. And here's Whiting with Stone on her. Oh, nice backdoor pass. Missing another layup. Andrews, be careful with the ball here. Andrews looked like she wanted to get rid of it and now throws to Stone. Jasmine Stott's going to be short. Oh, she gets the roll. Just over the front rim. Nice move by Jasmine. First bucket for Rollins. It took almost 4 minutes to get it, and the Tars back up by one. Woman to woman, and Whiting down low with Stone on her. Misses the shot, but draws the foul. She's not going to go to her left hand. And Jasmine went for that fake, and played good defense, but committed the foul. And Sabrina Whiting, who has not missed a free throw all year, will have two of them. 6:01 remaining. Tie game. Daniels coming out.
Right now, Robert, both teams still trying to establish their brand of play against the other, and it's really been a stalemate through the first 14 minutes.
Now, the Tars have given up a couple of easy baskets here. Yeah, I don't think Embry Riddle has quite yet. There's Andrews dribbling the ball, picks it up, and gives it to Conte. Oh, man. Conte looking backdoor. Now we'll throw it to McClendon. Tars just not getting inside. She picks up her dribble. And now Andrews.
And here's the thing, Robert, give credit to Embry Riddle. They extend their woman to woman. They're not going to let you drive inside. They get hands out all over the place. And they're going to force you to play around the perimeter and make you have a contested shot, or in this case, a contested pass that goes through the legs of McClendon.
9 turnovers for Rollins, 4 of them on Vernicia Andrews. 1-point lead, working on McClendon. Blocked by Carly. Great timing as usual. Here comes Andrews. Engler, who's checked back in to replace Conte. All open as Jasmine shoot it. And here's McClendon. She will turn and flip it up and draw the foul.
Draw the foul on Ellenberger, trying to close out late.
Nice feed inside Stone.
Actually, correction, they'll call a foul on McWilliams. Nope, Ackerman. Calling everybody. If you call somebody's name and say they get a foul, you eventually get the call right.
That's the third foul of the quarter on Embry Riddle. And that's going to fall for McClendon. Carly, the left-hander. 86% Stone will check out of the lineup, and Jablonski back in. Carly now to break this tie, left hands it up and won't go. 1-for-2 for McClendon for 3 points. Midway points, second quarter. 3 points in the quarter for Rollins, 4 for Embry Riddle. Driving it and now kicking it. Working inside, there's a hand check on Harrison.
And that's the 13th foul on the Tars, and it'll take us to our immediate timeout of this quarter. And you're seeing both defenses showcase their muscle. Teams combined 3-for-12 from the field in this second quarter. 9 combined points, and it's all tied up at 26.
Yeah, the Rollins Tars, amazingly, 10-for-21. Both teams are 10-for-21. Tars are 3-of-6 beyond the arc. Embry Riddle, 2-of-4. Embry Riddle's hit all 4 of their free throws. Rollins is 3-for-5 from the line. Fields picked up that second foul early in this quarter. And she is over on the bench. You think Coach Nuxall Wilson is going to bring her back in this quarter?
I think she'll bring her back, but very, very carefully. Maybe with 2 minutes left, maybe 1:30 left, because you don't want her to come back in off the timeout, pick up that third foul, and then you really limit what you could do with Fields for the remainder of this game.
Hey, both teams 6-0. Both teams ranked in the top 20 at the moment in the early season. Both teams 2-0 in the conference, but also Florida Southern and Nova 2-0. A lot of parity in this conference, don't you think?
Funny you should mention the conference, Robert. Looking around the league, Palm Beach Atlantic up 13-9 on Barry. 1:47 left to go in the first quarter. Down in Miami Shores, where the Tars will be on Saturday. Tampa rolling over St. Leo, 28-16. 5:03 left to go in the first half there. 8:15 left to go over at the Clemente Center. Florida Tech up on Lynn at 24-15.
Florida Tech picked up their first win here the other day against Talladega, looking for their second, and they leave Whiting alone. Boy, they are just absolutely, and here's another lazy pass that Ellenberger almost steals on the inbound. Whiting now with 7 points quickly in this quarter. In fact, she has all of the points in the quarter. Harrison to answer, in and out. And Jablonski climbing over the back of the Embry-Riddle player.
And it's something that right now, if you're Rachel, you're getting a golden opportunity with these injuries and a foul trouble on Bistro, trying to make an impact and kind of playing a little bit out of control now with the foul.
Here's Ellenberger against the Tars, woman to woman now. Looking down on the blocks, Sabrina Whiting. All conference type player. 4 minute mark, second quarter, 10 to shoot. Whiting wants the screen, goes around Engler, stop and go. Nice play by Julia Engler. And was she out of bounds?
Yeah, they say Engler, when she got possession, was out of bounds.
Let's see if they've given 30 seconds on the clock, because it's down to five. They're gonna say no possession?
Yeah.
It touched her while she was out of bounds. All right, so it's five to shoot. Tars cannot turn their head. They do not. Nice play, Andrews. And I don't know, they steal the basketball. Engler's open in the corner. Vernicia doesn't see her. And now Vernicia goes around an Engler screen and will put it up and one. Nice stop and go move, Vernicia Andrews, for her first points.
Andrews realizes that she gets that extra step on these Emery Riddle guards. It's just a matter of getting in that position quick enough in the offense to utilize that to her advantage. Draws the second foul on Emery Riddle on Tucker, and Andrews with the chance to tie it up at 29.
McWilliams and Savage check in for the Eagles. And that free throw is way off the mark. Andrews back down under 50% on the year. Tars trail by a point, 29-28. Handling the basketball is Koopman out front. Ball fake, McClendon does not take it. Ellenberger will work at top of the key. Good defense by the Tars with eight to shoot. They get it in the corner to Ellenberger, and she will fire it up. That's way off the mark. And here comes Andrews through traffic. They're coming from behind you. She gives it to Jablonski. Now to Harrison. Jalen Harrison gets lucky.
Yeah, right idea, bad timing.
Daniels in. Andrews out for Rollins. Tars trail by a point. They've only scored five in nearly 7 minutes of the quarter. Here's the inbounds play. And they get it to the other corner. Jablonski, three, is an air ball. Run down by Daniels. Tars now will have time. Harrison fires up a shot and misses. And away comes Embry Riddle. In a hurry, Ellenberger. They've got to cut her off. And McClendon tips the ball. And he goes top of the key. That shot's going to bank way off the mark. Jablonski, look out. And she comes away with it.
Fourth shot there by Savage. She looked very hesitant when she pulled it up.
And we're going to get a foul call on that drive by Double D.
And that's going to put Emery Riddle, it was going to put Rollins at the bonus. And that's going to be...
It's two shots anyway, I think, yeah.
Yep, Koopman's called for the foul.
Both teams in the double bonus at the moment. Denise Daniels steps to the stripe looking for her fifth point out of Colonial High School. Knocks it down. Making her first appearance, Ashley Muse, a 5'9 senior from Jacksonville. So Coach Nuxhall Wilson, she's used 11 players here so far. Second free throw, good again. That's why she's an 80%+ free throw shooter. Double D's got six. Tars back up by a point, kind of what you would expect here from two outstanding undefeated teams. Nice play, McClendon forces a missed shot. And here comes Harrison. Harrison with 2:20 remaining. We'll slow it down and back Ellenberger in, looking for help. Oh, they got McClendon on a shorter player, and Daniels tried to drive through traffic and cannot do it. And she now comes up with it, and a
nice
foul.
Block.
Oh, they're going to say a block.
What play, what hustle there by Ashley McWilliams. And Daniels had a chance to close it off. If she throws it off the glass, she probably gets the basket and the foul, but it says she takes it straight up. Gives McWilliams a chance to close out and get the block shot.
Now 12 to shoot with 2:10 remaining. Tars set up with their normal four across the lane. Pass inbounds under their offensive goal.
And now we have 12 to shoot. You got Daniels being fronted by Koopman. Try and spring her or Engler in the corner.
They do spring Engler. And she misses her first one. And Daniels has it knocked out of her hands. First one in nine attempts for Engler, but she did have a nice open look. 2:05 remaining, 30-29 Rollins. Going to try to set up Engler again. And now they need help, and Engler will get it. Fresh clock as we tick under 2 minutes. Harrison, who is scoreless in this one. And McClendon will turn, and her left-handed shot is good.
It's McClendon gets it behind the free throw line. When they do that little pick and roll, she can get that shot all night long. Tar's up by three.
Embry Riddle attacking the Rollins woman-to-woman. Oh, Ellenberger goes around. Harrison picks it up and gives to a wide-open Whiting. Off the mark, and McClendon again with another rebound. For Carly McClendon, that will be her eighth rebound. And Tars now with not very good spacing, and give it off to Engler. Like, double D goes around the defender, but cannot get it to go. Had a good look at it, could not get it to fall. Here comes Embry Riddle with 105 remaining, down by three. Well, they miss fields inside, don't they?
They certainly do.
Oh, it looked like a travel
and
on that
was.
Play.
Marissa Koopman took a little stroll in the middle of the lane. And Whitney Dunlap says a little bit too many steps as Shablonski will come back out for Jasmine Stone.
Now the Tars, with the clock ticking under 1 minute remaining in the half, have a three-point lead. Love to get a shot here. Let it run down just under 40. And get two for one. Engler now with Ellenberger on her back. We'll kick it off to Daniels, looking for McClendon inside. Clock is now at 43. Need to shoot it. Turnaround, Carly McClendon.
And now call a foul on Ellenberger, trying to clear out the position on Engler. And that's going to be her first.
Ellenberger will send Julia Engler to the line for a pair. Well, they've got one up there for her.
Yep, there was a foul originally called on Ellenberger, but it was then given to Nicole Tucker earlier in this quarter.
Engler now to give Rollins a four-point lead.
Surprisingly, Robert, 38 seconds left in this quarter, and that's her first point of the second quarter after having 13 in the first.
Julia, another one. Got it. Now the Tars should be able to get two for one out of this one. Engler two for three from the stripe. Here's Ellenberger, stop and go on Harrison. 15 to shoot, and Engler with the block. I checked that, McClendon with the block. What timing that was.
And now with Muse taking the shot too early, the Tars have a chance for the last shot of the half.
Got 12 seconds to do it. Jalen Harrison now looking for McClendon's screen, got it. Now kicks it over to Double D. That's going to be long. And that ball is tipped. And
a foul on Ellenberger. And a foul on Ellenberger before the buzzer went off.
And that's Tashiana what Smith is talking it over with her fellow officials. And it looked like she blew the whistle before the buzzer.
Exactly.
Oh, my goodness. That'll be the second on Ellenberger.
That's huge. That is huge because now, and I'm going to discuss how much time is left on the clock. Because if it's under 0.3 of a second, all he could do is just get a tip.
I've got zero up there. Oh, Julia.
No, I
got
to say.
Down just two for four.
Now they
got to put 0.3
up. 0.3 of a second. So if England misses a second, the only way the Tars can get a basket is on a tip in by Daniels or McClendon.
And she does miss them both. Boy, that is not going to happen probably for the rest of the year. As Julia Engler, coming in perfect at the line, is now just 2 of 5. But the Tars do take a five-point lead to the dressing room.
And really, Robert?
That was shocking.
What, the fact that Engler missed both of those free throws? It was a complete 180 from the second quarter.
Yeah, well, both, really. Tars with just 11 points in the quarter. Embry Riddle not doing too well either. Maybe has scored 9 in that quarter. So a tale of two quarters once again here at Rollins as the Tars take a 34-29 lead. And the shooting dropped dramatically in the second quarter.
Rollins 3 of 15, Embry Riddle 3 of 14. Teams combined 1 of 9 from the three-point line. And realistically, Robert, for Embry Riddle, who's given up the fewest rebounds in the conference, 29 per game, Rollins with 24 rebounds in his first half.
A plus nine, and I think a lot of that has to do with one Tara Fields on the bench.
It has a lot to do with it, picking up that second foul, a minute 30 into that second quarter. Really changed the complexion of how the rest of that first half was played.
She only played 8 minutes in the quarter, coming in averaging 18 points per game, picked up a couple of layups for four. But the Tars will go to the dressing room pretty happy with a 34-29
lead. You'll take it, but one thing you have to consider as well, Jay, especially with no points from Jalen Harrison, Joe Bistro, 5 minutes, two fouls, and V. Andrews only getting 2 points in 15 minutes.
All right, we're going to step aside for about 10 minutes. When we come back, we'll have all the stats, take you into the second half of the opening game of our Sunshine State Conference doubleheader. Two undefeated teams, the Rollins Tars and the Embry-Riddle Eagles. It's the Tars 34, the Eagles 29. You're listening to Rollins College Basketball on RollinsSports.com. He's Victor Anderson. I'm Robert Siegel. Stay with us. Back in 10.
We cannot be bystanders.
Taking action isn't always easy, but it's on us
to intervene.
Because we can. Learn more and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Champions know how to seize opportunities. When they see moments of greatness unfold right before their eyes, they push as hard as they possibly can, and then they push harder. Because the heart of a champion never settles, never quits, and never stops giving its all. We are champions. We are Division II. We go big, we give it everything we've got, and we win. On the field, on our campuses, in our communities, for our causes, in our careers. We rise to become champions in everything we do. We are Division II, and there are no limits here. We make our time count. We set our own path. We become champions on our terms. It's time to up your game, because we're here to play and learn. But most importantly, we're here to discover ourselves. Our vision, our heart, our drive to achieve every goal we aim for, because we want to be champions at the highest level, life. At Division II, the opportunities are here. Are you ready?
My name is T. I was playing basketball. I think it was my senior year. I actually played a game here at Rollins, and Coach Wilkes at the time, he's the women's basketball coach. I had a great game, and after the game, he was like, I love the way you play. I would like to offer you a scholarship. And I thought it was a beautiful campus, and I said, I'm here. It's something that has surprised me about Rollins is the faculty. I value, like, relationships. The faculty here has helped me connect with jobs. The professors are approachable, personable, they're understanding. They want us to strive for us to be our best. I feel like just being a student here at an elite college, I can actually set a goal that I want to pursue a meaningful life. So I want to pursue my passions in the field that I'm in. I can actually take what I'm learning in my education to a workplace. Now that I'm at Rollins, I've started finding my own path, and I think it's a great school. You have more opportunities than most to travel, meet people. You can conquer anything. My experience at Rollins has helped me develop leadership skills, critical thinking, being positive. I've learned so much as, like, just as a person. In a workplace, you're going to be working with different people with different backgrounds and different beliefs, and to learn to love, learn to be open, learn to love different perspectives. I think the Rollins culture has helped me kind of be overall a better person.
I've been reading books of old, the legends and the myths, Achilles and his gold, Achilles and his gifts, and Spider-Man's control, and Batman with his fist. And clearly I don't see myself upon that list. But she said, where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk? I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts, some superhero, some fairy tale bliss, just something I can turn to, somebody I can kiss. I want something just like this. Do 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 do. Oh, I want something just like this. Do do do.
Drive, quick work inside. Tars can't make the candle, though we'll get it to German. German will drive, German will shoot, and German will score. As Callie German.
Good job by Norelli to back up her teammates. Free ball sent back over to Wilson. Ball looked like it might have gone out, but instead, Cipriero gets a kill right in front of head coach Matt Affolder.
Where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk? I'm looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts, some superhero, some fairy tale bliss, just something I can turn to, somebody I can kiss. I want something just like this.
Here's her RJ jump number two. Looks like she's gonna take this one off the top. Decent kick. She'll ride it away. That's a good score. That's going to be up over 60 feet on her second.
Bicycle kick forward. A bicycle kick try from Diego. He'll take a glancing hit, and it's a goal. I don't believe it.
I feel like I'm taking crazy pills right now.
Same, me too.
Galvis skip pass over to Burton. Catches it in rhythm. Gets to the lane. Rises. Dunks it home.
Oh, Burton faked the three left corner drove into the lane, and nobody picked him up. He grabbed it.
Thank you.
I chose Rollins because the Spanish Mediterranean architecture is just beautiful. The weather's great. We're in central Florida. We're right on Lake Virginia, and I couldn't turn any of that down.
Rollins gave me that ability and that foundation that I needed to go into the world, and I think that I wouldn't have got that experience anywhere else.
Champions know how to seize opportunities. When they see moments of greatness unfold right before their eyes, they push as hard as they possibly can, and then they push harder. Because the heart of a champion never settles, never quits, and never stops giving its all. We are champions. We are Division II. We go big, we give it everything we've got, and we win. On the field, on our campuses, in our communities, for our causes, in our careers. We rise to become champions in everything we do. We are Division II, and there are no limits here. We make our time count. We set our own path. We become champions on our terms. It's time to up your game, because we're here to play and learn. But most importantly, we're here to discover ourselves. Our vision, our heart, our drive to achieve every goal we aim for, because we want to be champions at the highest level, life. At Division II, the opportunities are here. Are you ready?
We can stop to make sure someone is okay.
Welcome back, everybody, from the Alphon Sports Center at Winter Park, Florida. Getting ready to hit into the second half of the opening game of our Sunshine State Conference doubleheader as two undefeated teams are matching up here with the Rollins women holding a 34-29 lead over the Eagles of Embry-Riddle. I'm Robert Siegel. I'll be joined by Victor Anderson in just a moment. It was a three-point game at the end of the first quarter, 23-20, and then things really slowed down for both teams as the Embry-Riddle Eagles led by as many as five, and the Tars ended up with that five-point lead, even though the outstanding three-point and free-throw shooting Julia Engler missed two free throws with three-tenths of a second remaining. Tars ended up 39% from the field, 3 of 10 beyond the arc, only 7 of 12 from the line. They were a plus 9 rebounding the basketball. Joe Bistro with two fouls for Rollins. For Embry-Riddle, 38% from the floor, 3 of 8 beyond the arc. They hit all four of their free throws, and four of their five starters, everyone but Sabrina Whiting, picked up two fouls in that first half of action. 13 for Ellenberger, but she had 11 of those in the first quarter, I believe. For Rollins, they are being led by Engler with 15, but she had 13 of those in the first quarter. With four of the five starters for Embry-Riddle with two fouls, kind of imperative the Tars try to take the ball to the hoop, Victor.
Especially with the issues with Sabrina Fields. Rollins plus 9 in rebounding in the first half, 24-15. Haven't been able to capitalize on that. They only got an 8-second chance points in the paint, about even 16-14. They have to capitalize on their free throws. Rollins tripling Embry-Riddle in the free throw attempts. Rollins only 7-12. Embry-Riddle's hit all four of their shots at the line.
For the Rollins Stars, we said Bistro, the only player with more than one, so McClendon has managed to finish that first half. I think she had about at least three blocks in that first half, and I shouldn't say it, but did not pick up a foul. CMR Cruz is our lead official, working with Tashiana Smith and Whitney Dunlop, a veteran crew. Tars in the white, blue numerals, blue and gold trim. Embry-Riddle in the blue with gold numerals and trim. It will be the Eagles basketball. They will go left to right with that first possession under Lisa Nuxall-Wilson, the only coach this women's program has ever had in her fourth year, and Glenn Wilkes in his 32nd year looking for victory number 692. Tars will open in a zone. Ellenberger now And they kick it over to the side. Ooh, almost a lazy pass there. Looking for Fields inside. And now they get it to her. And quickly working that perimeter. Wide open three, top of the key. And great ball movement. And Tucker buries it. She's 46%. And right away, it's a two-point ball game as Embry-Riddle comes out of that dressing room, making a little bit of an adjustment against that Rollins zone. Baseline to Stone. Takes it in. Now try to answer and does. She gets a little 15-footer to go.
And really, Jospin has to be much more aggressive in the second half. She's going to have Ellenberger on her primarily. Can back her down to the basket. Has to utilize that matchup to her advantage.
Yeah.
She's going to match up to her advantage.
They switched on the play. And 5 feet, 4 inches of Jalen Harrison cannot control Tara Fields as McClendon comes out on the 5-4 Ellenberger. So 5 quick points in the first minute by Embry-Riddle. Harrison now working around Ellenberger. We'll throw it over to Denise Daniels. Nice move, Denise. She missed the shot but drew the foul.
And that's 3 on Fields. She picked up her second foul around this similar time in the second quarter. And Coach Nuxall Wilson is gonna keep her in. And you know Rollins will try to attack her the next few times they have the basketball.
Looks like they're whistling. Who are they whistling the foul on? They've got 14 up there. But 14 is not on the floor. In fact, I don't know if Embry-Riddle has a 14. Denise Daniels can give Rollins a 4-point lead.
Maybe they meant 13.
Yeah, that Daniels hits them both. He's got 8. And now they're taking another look at it, I guess.
Yeah, on the scoreboard, they have Fields with 3. And she's out
there.
No,
they don't.
But well, she's on. Well, you're not on the court.
And there's a foul by Andrews. Reaching in, got the wrist. And that'll be her second. They still don't have it up there. I hope they get it straight. Let's see.
Yeah, they do have it correct on. They do have it correct on the on our live stats.
Okay.
You can follow on TarsStats.com, by the way.
Sandstrom. That's the first foul on the Rollins Tars, and they do get it into Sandstrom. She's in that lane an awful long time.
Funny you should mention it. ZMR Cruz agrees with you, 3 seconds.
Yeah. She was waiting for the pass, then got the pass, then dribbled. And that's a call probably ought to see a little more, maybe. But CMR was right there on it. 4-point Rollins lead, led by 5 at the end of the second quarter. Boy, that was a lazy pass. Here is Andrews. Now works it over to Harrison. Good defense, as usual, by Ellenberger. And here is Harrison, offensive foul.
Led with the shoulder on Ellenberger, and she collides on the back of the right knee of Nicole Tucker. Thankfully, they're both all right. Harrison had her beat, but she decided to lean with the right shoulder just enough to get called for that foul.
Ellenberger doesn't take too many ball fakes. She is really tenacious and tough on the defensive end. Now, second foul on the Tars. Second foul on Jalen Harrison, the transfer from Georgia State out of Orlando, Florida. Clearing out down there is the Embry-Riddle player, Tucker. And now Tucker will step outside, miss the shot. Andrews will come away.
And that's going to be foul number 3 on Ellenberger, probably.
Let's see. That will be foul number 2 on Embry-Riddle. Yeah, you're right, Ellenberger. And she will do that. She wants to body you up. She wants to reach in there.
And now Embry-Riddle has, and now Embry-Riddle and Coach Lisa Nussall Wilson, they're going to have the Andrews with the inbound right in front of the scorer's table. That's where the foul occurred.
Taking out Sigrid Sandstrom,
who's been a not factor today.
And in comes Marissa Koopman, the German player for the Swedish player. Andrews. Again, tenacious defense is Harrison now. They take, and here is Andrews, and she loses the handle. There she goes back again. Now she needs to kick it back out, and we're going to have an offensive foul. She's had 5 turnovers in this game, just trying to do too much.
And 3 fouls in the first 2:33 of this third quarter, 2 of them on Andrews.
7:20 remaining, just a 4-point Rollins lead. Ooh, a travel outside by Koopman. Got away with it, now a steal by Harrison. Here comes Jalen, gets it up to Denise Daniels. She will bank it off the mark. Had a little more time than she thought, didn't she? And now up court quickly is Ellenberger with her three fouls. Andrews with three now for the Tars. Whiting got Stone on her. Can't let her get her three-point shot. Boy, backing it down inside is Tucker. And now with 10 to shoot, Ellenberger around a screen. And Ellenberger will put it up and in. Going to go to her right. Ellenberger now with 15. Asmund Stone, two-point Rollins lead, 38 to 36. Almost threw that one away. Denise Daniels now will take it all the way and bank it in.
And one.
I think they can do that quite a bit more than they have been.
And that foul's going to be called on this. They're going to call that foul on Koopman. That's going to be her second. So the fouls starting to rack up on both sides. Each team with three fouls, not even 4 minutes into this third quarter.
Coming into the game, replacing Harrison.
Summer
will be
Conte.
Summer Conte, yeah. And Engler's also stepped onto the floor. And Andrews will sit.
And with the two quick fouls Joe Bistro picked up in that first quarter, Coach Glenn Wilkes is going more to his freshman from Louisville, hoping he can get some production as Daniels completes the three-point play.
Daniels with 11 points. Up in double figures, averaging just under 14. Ellenberger now is Embry-Riddle trails by five. That's their biggest deficit. Nice feed inside, and now top of the key. Good ball movement, but the shot is missed. And jumping in there with the rebounds, Whiting, she cannot control it. And Engler, oh, man. Dribbling with a player coming right up behind her. Stone's long three is good. Jasmine now with five in the quarter, nine in the game, gives Rollins their biggest lead of eight. And here comes Ellenberger.
Stone five. And Stone and Harris, then Daniels have combined for all the 10 points the Tars have in this third quarter. Coach Nuxall Wilson looking for an answer, especially with Fields on the bench with that third quick foul.
Sabrina Whiting now looking for Ellenberger. Not there. Boy, right up on her is Jasmine Stone, but I guess not close enough to get that call. Nice shot by Whiting. That ball goes off of her foot, and there's a battle for it, and away comes Embry-Riddle, and the shot clock will go off as there was no possession by the Rollins Stars. Good effort, Jasmine. Big smile on her face.
And the thing with Jasmine, we talk about her shooting, Robin, and rightfully so. Very underrated defender. You saw in that last possession.
And the Stars with that inbound pass. Here comes Ellenberger. Oh, man. Rollins now loses the handle again, and we're going to have a timeout or a foul.
Stone going over the back. Now the question is, did they call a timeout or did a foul occur before the timeout?
They called it a timeout, it looked like.
And that's
you just can't be slow dribbling up court with Ellenberger behind you.
Yep, you have to be. And nobody, again, no communication.
Yeah, exactly.
Nobody's yelling, hey,
exactly.
Behind you, like, ball. We do that in pickup basketball all the time. Someone come around and say, ball. You got to be careful of that.
Yeah, she should have known. I mean, she saw her back there as checking her ankle out is Sigrid Sandstrom, the sophomore out of Sweden. Timeout on the floor. Victor, let's thank our sponsors.
In sports like in life, it takes hard work and dedication to be the best. And that's where Career Source Central Florida comes in. Career Source Central Florida can guide you and your business to be the best they can be. Their team of highly trained business consultants are available to help you hire, train, and expand your team. They tailor their recruitment services to fit your needs. So if you're looking for the best, visit them at careersourcecf.com and get started today and build your team of qualified talent. Career Source of Central Florida, as always, tailored from every angle, your angle.
And we appreciate all of our sponsors. As you see right behind the bench, Tiana Rosser with that cast on her right leg. She'll be ready to play next year, everybody says, and that's great to hear. She got injured but the
Florida Tech game, and as really took the air out of the arena as the Tars were rolling along as Rosser had a layup.
She was rolling along.
She certainly was.
Yeah, it's her junior year, so I believe she'll have 2 years of eligibility remaining. Here comes Ellenberger now as Conte has checked in, and she will check Ellenberger as Fields easy shot misses, and McClendon comes down with her the 10th rebound of the game. Tars now as we tick under 5 minutes. Denise Daniels, double D on the dribble. Keeps that dribble going. Gives it off to Conte, the freshman. Conte looking for help. And now we'll cross over at the line. 17-footer. Daniels will rattle out. And Ellen Berger in there for the rebound in a hurry. And has it tipped by Daniels. Oh, great quick hands by Double D that time. Knocks it out of bounds.
And that's going to take us to our media timeout of the third quarter. And of course, with the rules, first timeout of the half, media timeout. And of course, under 5 minutes of the quarter, that'll take us to our media timeout.
Ellen Berger playing in there with her three fouls. That's going to slow her down probably a little bit defensively. Fields also with three fouls for the Tars. Andrews with three fouls is on the bench. Bistro will be checking in when we come back to action here. So, again, kind of a low-scoring quarter, 10 points for the Tars, and a 7 so far for Embry-Riddle, but the Eagles have the basketball.
Eagles who have the basketball. Take a look around the league, Robert. 8:28 left to go in the third quarter. Florida Tech cruising over Lynn, looking for their second straight win. Panthers up 12, 48-36. Tampa with a comfortable lead over St. Leo, 37-21. They get ready to start the second half at the Bowman Activity Center. Barry up on Florida, Palm Beach Atlantic, 54-44. 10 seconds left to go in the third. And Ecker, the reigning regular season and tournament champions, looking to knock Florida Southern off the ranks of the undefeated. Tridents up by 5, 46-41. 4:17 left to go at the MacArthur Center.
Yeah, Ecker comes into that 5-1, 1-1 in the conference. Southern 6-1, 2-0 in the conference early season. Here go the Embry-Riddle Eagles in the blue going left to right. Ellen Berger looking for Fields as she bodies up on McClendon. They're going to need to help her out a little bit, and Fields' left-handed shot is no good. That rebound will be tipped over to Engler. Now they get it up ahead to Conti. Conti on the run. Does not have numbers. Will slow it down. Good move for the freshman, but got Ellen Berger on her now. Picks up her dribble in the corner and gets it out to Engler. Julia. Kicks it over on the side. Engler guarded by McWilliams. As Daniels goes baseline and needs some help. Give it to Engler. Engler unleashes off the back iron. Long rebound to Whiting. Sabrina Whiting under 4 minutes remaining. Player, freshman of the year in the old Sun Conference. Fields in that lane a long time and will bank it in. Wow, stand in the middle of the lane and then dribbled and stayed in the lane, and she's got 8. Cuts the Rollins lead to 6. Not much you can do behind her. She is a formidable low post presence. Now Engler gets it over to McClendon, double team. Bistro, wide open is Conte, left-handed shot off the mark. And away comes Ellen Berger. Ellen Berger slows it down, top of the key, 3:10 remaining. She will back it up. And now hand it off. They're looking for Fields. McClendon playing behind her. Now gets it on the baseline. Jumper on the side is going to be short. And a rebound tipped by Engler, but right back into the hands of Ashley McWilliams.
Rollins has to do a much better job closing out those possessions. They're going to try and bang into Fields. Hope she can get a kick out in the corner to one of the wide open shooters. There they go again.
There's Fields. Yeah, she's going to go to her right, missing the shot. You know she's going to go to her right. If they let her stand in the lane that long, she is deadly. He was standing right in the middle of the lane, got the pass, dribbled to the right side of the lane, and got the foul.
And only the first on McClendon. And we have to give Carly McClendon a lot of credit, Robert. Ever since Rosser went out with an injury, she's been a much smarter and still effective defensive player.
Not much you can do, seriously. If they're going to let her stay in the lane. 71% shooter. Fields now cuts it to 5 as McClendon, Engler, and Conti check out. Andrews will check in along with Jalen Harrison and Rachel Jablonski, the freshman. Tars go to a much shorter lineup as Fields gets them both. Nice soft touch. And she's got 10 as here comes Andrews. Andrews, they back off of her. She is not a three-point threat. Oh, man. Jablonski gives it to Andrews. Andrews will take it into the lane and lose the handle. We're going to have a reach-in foul.
Oh, McWilliams, that's her fourth. That's her first team's fourth.
2:26 remaining. Tars up by 4, but have hit one of their famous lulls. Now they're going to inbound it with that double screen there. Now Andrews, skip pass over to Daniels. Denise has it, have a pocket picked. And Sabrina Whiting will send out Embry-Riddle. And tipped out of bounds And a good defensive play by Jalen Harrison. Check with the other official. Well, they didn't do it. But Jalen thought she had tipped it off the leg of the Embry-Riddle player, Tucker. And Fields is battling and bodying up on Andrews down there. She definitely has a height advantage now. Right now they got her inside, and she will turn and spike it. That's way too easy. You and I could still do that.
And really with Daniels on her, she knows if she just gets good position on Daniels, she'll get it wide open in the paint. All of a sudden, it's a one-possession game.
Here's Harrison. Tars have not scored in the last 4 minutes. And they won't. Coach Wilk clapping it up over there, but cannot be happy with the offensive possessions in the last 4 minutes. 2-tie, 3-take the lead, as 6 consecutive points now by Embry-Riddle in the last 100 seconds. Oh, right around. Nice play by Daniels. And Andrews will get it. She's got somebody coming behind her, and she gets it to Bistro. Joe Bistro will take it all the way. Score. There you go, Joe.
Nice job by Bistro. Nice. Dalaba, she's going to go into the traffic. They close in. She found a little sliver on the left-hand side and gets it off the backboard. Torres get the lead back to 4.
You know, Fields with 3 fouls, not going to take a chance. And Fields now bodying up on Daniels, and, man, that's easy. That's all she does is shoot the layups, but if you let her get a pass on the blocks, you're dead. She's got 10 in the quarter and 14 in the game. And McClendon's still on the bench. Fields now to cut it to a one-point game. Having a Fields day down low. Misses that one, though. Ball is tipped. And Embry-Riddle wanted it a little more, and they come away with the rebound. And they throw it to Fields. And it's blocked by Andrews. Harrison will get it up ahead to Andrews. Do not have the numbers. In fact, she outnumbered. Kicks it over to Daniels. Harrison works to Denise Daniels. She will take it all the way in. And cannot finish.
A little too high of the glass.
They've got about a 10-second difference, shot clock, game clock, trailing by 2. And Fields sets the screen, rolls to the basket, and standing in the lane. Ellenberger with 12 to shoot. Looking for Fields inside. Now she's going to set a screen for Ellenberger, and that ball is tipped with 5 to shoot. Now Ellenberger wide open for 3, backs it up with the ball fake, misses the shot, and that's it. That's the shot clock. Did it hit the rim?
That's what they're arguing. I thought it may have grazed the side of the right on the right rim.
Yep, they're going to say it's Embry-Riddle basketball with 9.7. So they can tie or take the lead here at the end of the quarter. They're going to look for Fields. Fields bodying up on Bernicia. And instead, they get the ball off to Tucker.
And good job by Coach Nuxall Wilson. They forced Rollins to collapse on Fields, camping in that block right on the outside of it. And Tucker kind of sneaks her way behind, gets the basket and a chance to give the Eagles a lead with 8.2 remaining.
It's a 10-2 run here late in the quarter. And missing the shot as Daniels now will rebound it. They were going to put McClendon in. And with 3 seconds left, you're going to have to shoot it, Denise. Tied up. 3 quarters of action. Coach Wilk smiling. Seems to be happy with the play, even though it was a 10-2 run there at the end of the quarter. I wonder if he's talking about 3 seconds in the lane.
And that's what he's probably talking about these with the officials. And the thing with Fields, you know in your mind, 1-1000, 2-1000, step your foot out of the lane, reset, get yourself back in, and here's the thing. Fields is doing a great job of utilizing when they don't have McClendon on the court to her advantage. 6 of those 10 points she had in that fourth quarter were with McClendon out on the floor after she picked up that first foul with 2.5 minutes left in the third quarter. So right now, McClendon with only the one foul. You have to be smart, as they know they're going to try and pound the ball back inside the fields. But can Embry-Riddle utilize that to their advantage and hit some three-pointers? Only 4-12 from three in the first three quarters. They're the number two shooting team in the league from downtown in this season.
Yeah, Ellenberger with just 2 points in that quarter has got 15. Whiting was shut out in that quarter. It was all Tara Fields, and Fields now with 14 points. Tucker also had a good quarter. She has got 7. So we go to the fourth quarter, tied at 46. So Rollins had 23 in the first quarter. They've had 23 in the next two quarters combined. They wear the white, blue numerals, blue and gold trim. Both teams 6-0, 2-0 in the conference. Embry-Riddle in the blue, gold numerals, and gold trim. Are they going to set a screen? Yes, they are. Here we go. As Ellenberger back into the ballgame with her three fouls. They've nursed it along foul-wise. Jasmine Stone wanted to drive, but there was too much traffic in there. And now Harrison looking down low for McClendon. Not there. Well, McClendon will set a screen, and Jalen Harrison will go in and lose the handle. Got to shoot it. Don't know what she was doing. She had the ball at her waist and then lost it, I guess.
Yeah, I think she was too worried about trying to get that fourth foul on
Fields was backing away. Fields was playing smart and just had her hand straight up. Tied at 46. They're looking for Fields. Now they give it inside. Blocked by McClendon. That time the pass was a little too long. She was under the basket. And now Harrison at midcourt. Jalen Harrison. Blue number 4 on her back. Being guarded by the much slower Marissa Koopman. And here's the drive by Stone. And Jasmine with 7 in the half, 11 in the game. Got it turned back. Here comes Ellenberger. Ellenberger. Now they're going to look for Fields. McClendon trying to front her a little bit here. Doing a little different something defensively. Ellenberger does get it to Fields. Fields up and under. And she walks with the basketball.
And McClendon, she's being a little bit more aggressive with Fields in the first. She played her the first three quarters, Robert, trying to cut in front of her, deny that initial entry pass, and when she's getting in front of her, getting a little bit of contact. That's the luxury in the rope that you give yourself when you only have one foul.
Also make her go to her left. She
exactly.
Don't want to do that. She wants to just go right. And here is Harrison, three-pointer off the iron. Rebound will be snatched down by Embry-Riddle and a foul by Jalen Harrison in backcourt. Ellenberger's going to get the ball and go. You know that. Harrison a little late getting over there, and that's her third first team foul on Rollins. Now she's going to dog Ellenberger in backcourt. Not a terribly good idea. Ellenberger can handle it beautifully. Now they get it to Fields. Going to go to her right. Now kicks it back. McClendon on her. Look out. She's going to go to her right and banks it up. Don't have to play the left hand. Tied at 48. So the 8-minute mark of the fourth quarter. Going down to the wire with this one. Jalen Harrison, she is scoreless in this game. Gives it off to Engler. Now Engler will throw it out to Stone. Engler being guarded by McWilliams, who's doing a good job. Now they switch. Jasmine will take it all the way. Missed the shot. Got everything but the finish. Here's Ellenberger into the lane. Saul McClendon backed it out. Again, looking for Fields. Fields using that arm to ward off McClendon. 7:25 remaining, tie ball game. Now they get it to Fields. They kick it back up to the top of the key. That ball tipped by Stone. 7 to shoot. They see the shot clock. And now trying to get it off in time. And getting it off in time, but traveling first. 1 second. Good defense that time. McClendon has the much shorter. McWilliams did look at the clock and did head to the hole.
And could we have a timeout called by Coach Lisa Nuxall-Wilson and Embry-Riddle. Surprisingly, only the first timeout called by the Eagles. That is going to take us to our media timeout. And, Robert, if you think about it, this is playing exactly how we thought it was going to be. That first quarter was probably the anomaly with it being 23-20 in a hot shooting start. Low scoring, defensive battle, both teams trying to grind one out for a victory. And right now, if you're Embry-Riddle, you're playing with a lot of confidence because you've gotten Fields going in that third quarter, and you're trying to ride her and trying to get her to that, get you to that victory.
She's got 16, Ellenberger 15 for the Tars, 15 for Engler, 11 each for Daniels and Jasmine Stone. The rebounding in this half, a plus four for Embry-Riddle, and that's a lot to do with Fields being on the floor for the Eagles. McClendon does have 10 boards, but only 5 points in this one. They have not found her on the blocks with that left-handed shot.
It's really, Robert, one of those things where give Tara Fields a lot of credit for denying her on that left hand and either forcing McClendon to go right or try and get it, try to make a move, kick it back out, and reset the offense.
They really haven't been able to get entry passes into her, and that's through the tenacious defense of Embry-Riddle out front. 48 apiece, 7:14 remaining. Nobody to inbound the basketball. And now Denise Daniels will throw it in. Double D. We'll get it into McClendon. And then we'll bring it up. Daniels on that dribble. They want to get it to Harrison to start the offense. And here they go. Jaylen is scoreless in this ballgame. 0 for 5 from the floor. There's McClendon. That's what we were just talking about. And she will bank it up short. And,
You say reaching on Stone, it looks like. Nope, they're calling on McClendon.
Short on that shot. Well, just what we were talking about. They got it to her in her left hand, but that's a second foul with 6:55 remaining. And now you know they're going to start battling to get it to Tara Fields. McClendon's trying to front her. And Fields is backing her in.
Travel.
And we're going to have a travel, yeah.
Fields is getting so anxious when she gets that ball on the block, when she takes a couple steps a little bit too soon while she's establishing position on McClendon. That's the third turnover she's had in this quarter.
Yeah, she uses that arm pretty well to ward off McClendon, but you know she's going to her right hand. Here's Daniels, now to Harrison. Tied at 48. So far, 2 points apiece, and there's a shot put up and in by Carly McClendon, her first points of the second half. Now Fields, and they lob it inside, and Engler comes to help. Oh, my. Oh, my. And then they call it on Julia Engler. She was about a half step slow to help there. That's the third foul on Rollins in less than 4 minutes. None yet on Embry-Riddle. Tars have got to be ready. They're inbounding the ball, and Rollins is talking to each other. And Ellenberger now kicks it over on the side and gets it back. Top of the key, Sabrina Whiting. Nobody home. She gives Embry-Riddle a 1 point lead. Nobody home on the outstanding Sabrina Whiting. Now looking for McClendon. McClendon kicks it off to Daniels. Drive on her, down 15 footer, buries it. 7.5, 13 in the game for a Double D. 1 point Rollins lead, 52-51. Oh, almost got a steal and a run out as Whiting now being guarded by Stone. 15 to shoot, 5:20 remaining, fourth quarter.
Gonna call Harrison for the reach, and that's gonna be her fourth.
And the team's fourth. Every foul now in the last 5:25 will be two shots, and this is a team that shoots 78% as a team. That is outstanding free throw shooting. Tars in trouble now. Harrison with four. And the team with four. Ellenberger. Ball fake. Nobody was near her. She throws it on the baseline. Ball fake and now falls down. Tipped by Denise Daniels. Now 3-on-1 by Harrison. We'll get it off to Stone. Who will miss the shot.
And we'll have a foul on Koopman closing out on Engler, who got that rebound.
Jasmine, a little too strong on that finish. And now that'll just be the first foul.
Well, my apologies, that's on Nicole Tucker. That's going to be her third.
Bernicia Andrews back in, and Jasmine Stone will sit.
Now
they got to inbound the basketball.
Wow.
Just barely. Wow, that looked like 5 seconds to me. Tars just do that little screen on the side. It's pretty much the same inbounds play that they've always used. And that time didn't get the screen going. There's Andrews. They back off of her. And she's going to jump it up way off the mark. That's not what you're looking for. Sabrina Whiting now to Ellenberger. They are a great guard combination. Ooh, look like a little shuffle in. He banks it in. How about that one for Morgan Ackerman? 2-point Embry-Riddle lead. Andrews. Wow, they're going to Ackerman now coming out to guard her. Just hit a shot, so she's going to guard Andrews tightly. And that's to the Tars advantage because Andrews not going to shoot it. Down by 2, 4 minutes remaining. Harrison is scoreless. Harrison, nice move. Now with 6 to shoot, gives it off to Daniels. Daniels' runner is good. Daniels now with 15, ties the game at 54. Harrison coming out to play Ellenberger. That's a challenge with those 4 fouls. And she gets screened off. Ellenberger is non-stop out of Granger, Indiana. Nice pass inside. Banking it up and in is Koopman for her 5th point, averages 3.
And the problem is Andrews couldn't close out because she has 4 fouls as well. Timeout called by Glenn Wilkes.
Still happy about what's going on out there. 2-point deficit now. As the Rollins Tars trail 56-54. Fields has been on the bench for the last 3 or 4 possessions. But it has not slowed Embry-Riddle down as Koopman with a bucket and Ackerman, the Lake Mary product, throwing one in off the backboard. Averages about a point a game as 3 in that one. Now 56-54, Rollins with the ball and a deficit. What are you looking for?
Well, Robert, you have Andrews and Harrison with 4 fouls. So if they're going to drive, they have to be cognizant if they're going to draw contact that they do everything they can to remain vertical, don't get called for that charge and get called for that 5th foul. They have to find a way to get Engler back going. She hit 13 in the first, hasn't hit a field goal since. So can they get Engler back going?
Going to look for McClendon as Fields is out. And she is going to be guarded over there by Nicole Tucker. Now they got McClendon out of the lane. And they're going to let Denise Daniels go one-on-one. She gets in trouble. Engler, 3.
I think they must have heard what we were talking about, Mr. Siegel.
But Ellenberger, boy, she pulled up there. All she had between her and the basket was Jalen Harrison and her 4 fouls. As driving it in. And boy, that was easy. Went right around Andrews. Did Tucker. And Tucker now with 9. Just a freshman. It's going to be a good one here for Coach Nuxall Wilson. And Engler loses the handle. Keeps her dribble going, however. And will take it all the way in and score. Engler now with 20 points. And the Tars in the woman-to-woman. 59-58, rebound on the miss by Daniels. Denise will kick it over to Engler. Engler in backcourt with Ellenberger on her, slows it down. Down to 2:10 remaining, 1-point Rollins lead. Coach Wilkes holds up 1 finger. And he gets that screen from McClendon. Looking for McClendon down low. You can't angle it across there. Now they give it into Andrews. And she scores. She kept herself under control that time.
That's really the key. She did it under control. Didn't want to extend that left arm trying to get the clear out. He docked up to 3.
There's Whiting. Got to stay out on her. Down to 15 to shoot. 135 remaining. 3-point Rollins lead.
Timeout.
On the screen, Sabrina Whiting, and now we got 10 to shoot. Timeout.
Timeout called by Lisa Nuxall-Wilson. It seems she's going to use her last 30 or she's going to use a full timeout. It's going to use her last 30-second timeout here. 10 on the shot clock, 1:32 left to go. And, Robert, if you think about it, they're going to try and set a screen for Ellenberger or Whiting along the wing off the inbound pass when we come back for the timeout.
The downside here is that any foul by Rollins is 2 shots, the double bonus. The other side, only 1 foul on Embry-Riddle. So if they're trailing toward the end of the game, they're going to have to foul a lot. And Tara Fields will be coming back in. She's been sitting for the last couple of minutes.
And really, Fields is in to do two things. Rebound and get a look in the paint. Why, remember the play that they ran early in the third quarter? Fields was right on the right block. They collapsed on her. They gave a wide open three-pointer. They gave a wide open three-pointer to Morgan Ackerman, and she buried it. So look for something similar coming off of this inbound play.
Yeah, they're going to look for the three and then go for the field. Here is Ellenberger, top of the key. Now they do get it to Fields. Now she'll kick it back out. Ellenberger with two to shoot. And that's a shot clock file. How can they do that?
Wow.
How can a veteran team not get the shot off?
That is a rare mental mistake by senior leading guard backcourt by Emery Riddle.
They were not looking at the basket with that shot clock running down. They knew it was 10 when they came out of the timeout. Now we've got a minute 15 remaining. Engler now will hand the ball off, and we're going to have a reach-in foul. That'll only be the second.
Yep. When you have low fouls in late game situations, Robert, you can afford to be a little risky, trying to get a little chance in that passing lane. Now the problem is that's the
four foul. And they're
going to
jump the passing lanes here. Better be crisp with the passes. They get it to Harrison with her four fouls. Ellenberger on her. 1:10 remaining. 3-point Rollins lead. Looking for a bucket. Looking to get a two possession game. Andrews now jumps it up. Oh my goodness. Oh, she hits a 15-footer. Felicia Andrews with back-to-back buckets. Stars up by five. Stolen by Denise Daniels. Daniels, look out. And how did she not know that Ellenberger was behind her?
Daniels knew she had him run out, but good job by Ellenberger knocking it out of the hands. Glenn Wilkes says, let's take a 30-second timeout. Let's calm everybody down. Looks like it's going to be a full timeout for Coach Glenn Wilkes.
That Ellenberger is just a terrific player. She gets off the bus competitive and just hustles and hustles and knocked that ball out of bounds. Daniels about to pick it up and lay it in with 52 seconds left and a 5-point lead for the Rollins Stars.
And tremendous. And how about V. Andrews playing in control with the four fouls? She gets the layup, hits the pull-up jumper, ends up getting a steal. Almost Daniels almost gets the run out with a nice tip or out of bounds by Ellenberger. So now we got 52 seconds left, 28 seconds on the shot clock. Possession arrow and held in the favor of a jump ball gives it to Emery Riddle. As Robert alluded to, next Rollins foul will send the Eagles to the line to shoot two. Rollins only two team fouls for Emery Riddle, so they have a lot of work to do, especially if they can't.
Well, obviously you want to try to run off as many of those 28 seconds as you can.
Yeah.
On the other side, Lisa Nuxhall-Wilson may opt to foul a couple of times going for steals in order to set it up to where, if she needs to, she can foul and stop the clock and put Rollins at the line.
Trying to extend the game as long as possible.
Now they got to inbound the ball, and they've had some trouble doing that. Andrew's not sure of what the inbounds play was, looking at the old inbounds play. Now they bring it in, and they need help, and they have it tipped away, and McClendon will run it down. McClendon now will get it to Daniels. Down to 20 seconds on the shot clock. Not 42 seconds in the fourth quarter. But Daniels now out near midcourt. Now gets to Jalen Harrison with 12 on the shot clock. Behind her back on the screen. Gives to Daniels. Now to McClendon. Up and banking. Short. Short-armed it again.
Don't need a three here, Robert.
25 seconds left now.
You don't need a three.
5-point lead as Ellenberger.
Call a foul on McClendon. And she is slow to get up. And that's only the third foul on McClendon.
But it's two shots.
Yep.
So Ellenberger, stop and go move. She will go to her left. There's no question about that. Boy, McClendon had everything she wanted and just short arm that banker. And now Ellenberger can cut it to four and maybe three here. Ellenberger is she's only 4 for 4 on the year. But she is a great free throw shooter. She hits that one.
Timeout situation. Emery Riddle with a 60-second timeout remaining. Rollins with 230-second timeouts remaining.
Cuts it to two. 17 points. And now Emery Riddle will call a timeout. Rollins can bring it up to half court if they want. I believe they can, even though Emery Riddle called the timeout.
But they do have to. No, the Rollins has to call a timeout to advance the ball up court.
Okay, so this timeout does not do it. All right, that's the rule in women's basketball. Now, with just two fouls, Embry-Riddle has got to go for the steal and the foul.
Yep. And realistically, Robert, as we talked about, you could be aggressive getting those passing lanes, but every tenth of a second you don't get that foul, that's less time you have to work with. Now, if you're Rollins, once you get that fifth foul, you have to get the ball in your hands of your best foul shooters.
That's why I was going to ask you, do you leave Andrews in the game?
You kind of have to take her out because Andrews only shoots 47%. Daniels at 80% shooter from the free throw line. Jalen Harrison, 70%. Carly McClendon, 85%. Maybe you put in Joe Bistro, who shoots 87% from the line, and Julia Engler, who prior to came into this game, had not missed a free throw, was 2 of 5. Maybe those two free throws in the first half to close the half, falling short, maybe in her head a little bit. So you figured that might be the lineup you go to. But it wouldn't be surprised if you put Andrews in, trying to get the ball up, and then we have to get that fourth foul, serve her out for Joe Bistro.
He is out of the game. As checking back in is Jasmine Stone. So you got Daniels, Engler, Harrison, McClendon, and Jasmine Stone. Now the Tars have got to inbound the ball with 21 seconds left and a three-point lead, 63-60. Now they set the screen and call a timeout.
Smart play. You got two timeouts left, and Coach Wilkes is saying, hey, run the play. So 30-second timeout. He only has two of them left.
Well, they set one screen, and that was it. And now he can bring it up to half court, and he's going to.
Yeah, but that's really kind of the fallback plan that we talked about, Robert. If you can't get the inbound, you have a timeout to use. You can bring the ball past midcourt, get yourself a little bit of relief.
I always think it's easier at the end line when you can run the baseline.
But the thing was, he couldn't run the baseline in that particular situation since Embry-Riddle called a timeout. If Rollins had called a timeout.
I believe she could have run the baseline.
Okay.
Yeah. It was a made shot, and Rollins had the ball. They could have run the baseline. They did not.
Yep, that's
it. And now they're going to inbound at midcourt, and they've had trouble inbounding the ball historically. This is a tough place to inbound the ball.
Yeah, got a stack.
Right in front of the Rollins bench across the way to our left. Now they run a little circle thing, and they give it to the Jalen Harrison. And Harrison's going to get fouled.
And that's the fourth on Ellenberger.
Ellenberger picks up her fourth foul. Now the Tars will inbound right here. And that is the third foul on Embry-Riddle. They will foul quickly again. They're going to set up that same play. Give it to McClendon. Now back to Denise Daniels. They're not out getting her. They're not going to foul her. What's going on? Wide open is Stone. Stone's got to pass it back out. Well, either way, 10.8 seconds left.
Now, that could be.
Is that an intentional?
Well, no. I want to say that was a little bit of a too hard of a shove on Fields, and that's her fourth. And the discussion now was that
an
intentional.
Why didn't they foul on Daniels?
Now, here's the question. What they're discussing now, is that an intentional foul?
No, it's not. They're not going to call it. They never do. And
What are we doing here? They thought the whistle blew, signaling the inbound play, but now
10.8 seconds left. Rollins with a three-point lead. They've been getting the ball into McClendon, and now they've got Harrison in backcourt. We're going to have a timeout. They had Jalen Harrison in backcourt wide open, and Daniels didn't see her.
Yep.
As they do want to get the ball, if possible, to Denise Daniels. Well, Daniels is going to inbound it. So they want to get it to McClendon or Engler.
Yes.
And now they're going to inbound the ball on the side with just a three-point lead. Is that the last timeout?
Both teams out of timeouts, Robert. And right now, if you're the Tars, you got to get the inbound, control the ball. And then the fact that they backed up off Daniels before the last inbound, that's at least 4 or 5 seconds that they could have had back.
Yep. Now four fouls on Ellenberger and Fields if you're thinking the possibility of overtime here.
And Tucker as well with four fouls. So if you're Embry-Riddle, if you're going to foul, it's going to have to be McWilliams, who only has one.
All right, here we go. Inbounding the ball across the way in front of the bench. It'll be Denise Daniels, double D. They're swinging around in a circle. Now they're going to go into the backcourt. Jasmine Stone gets fouled.
And that's Whiting. She gets fouled.
Jasmine's only 5 of 12 on the year. She's now 7 of 14. And that will be two shots. That's the fifth foul. Why is everybody fooling around over there? She's going to the line. It's five fouls. Okay,
yep.
Now we know.
Yep, so
and
now.
And that's the fifth foul, by the way, on Tucker.
As Tucker. Wow, I thought that foul was called on Whitey.
Well, it says 32 on the board there.
That's what I'm saying.
Wait a minute. Am I getting this correct?
No,
here?
Whiting was the one that ran into Stone. So, and they deliberately did that because Whiting has because Tucker has four with Ellenberg and Fields.
Right,
so that's
now,
why they had Whiting do the foul.
Jasmine
she only
has to
one
make
now.
One of these two to give a 4-point lead for Rollins. Otherwise, it stays a one possession game. Free throw is good. Senior coming through.
8 points for Jasmine in the second half, Robert.
12 overall. Needs one more for a 5-point lead. And got it. And we're going to have a substitute.
The Andrews is going to come in.
Is coming in for
Stone.
Jasmine Stone gets a big hand. Somebody's got to come up court. They're going to roll the ball in. Somebody's got to come up court and make them pick it up.
They're just going to let that ball roll.
I don't understand that. Okay, here comes Harrison now. She's going to make her pick it up. 9 seconds left. 5-point Rollins lead. 3-pointer by Whiting. Off the mark. Rebound McClendon. And the Tars are going to win this game as Whiting commits the foul. So the Tars come down the stretch, and they're going to go 7-0, 3-0 in the conference, and hand Embry-Riddle their first loss of the season. So it was a close one, as we had anticipated. Embry-Riddle had been absolutely swamping their opponents. And this time the Tars took the bit late, and they're going to win this game.
How about V. Andrews, Robert, down the stretch, those two, that layup and then the jumper.
Amazing, yeah. Harrison, by the way, is looking for her first point of the game. Figure averaging an 11, hitting shots at a 48% clip, but would be her first point if she can make it, and does. And now to inbound the ball. And firing it down. And battling to the end is Lauren Ellenberger. And the Tars remain undefeated at 7-0. But this nice crowd here on hand got themselves a heck of a basketball game.
You could consider this first test for Rollins basketball pass for this season. They knew Embry-Riddle was going to dole at him with a tremendous defensive effort. Rollins battled back and forth. Embry-Riddle took the lead late. But V. Andrews, Jasmine Stone down the stretch, and Julia Engel with a big three-pointer late in the fourth quarter. And the Tars get themselves a 66-60 win, and they remain perfect on the season.
V. Andrews, very happy coming off the court. She sure did. She had that drive when the Tars needed a bucket, and then she just went up cool as a cucumber and threw in a 14-footer there. Back-to-back buckets, and that's what gave the Tars the momentum to win this game.
And really, Robert, it comes back down to limiting Embry-Riddle. Embry-Riddle shot 5 of 8 in the fourth quarter, 2 of 3 from 3. But the problem is, Rollins went 8 of 14, 3 of 4 from the line, and they really limited Embry-Riddle late to one-and-done possessions, and those turnovers early on in the fourth quarter, I feel, cost the Eagles a chance to come away with the road victory.
So the Rollins Stars will go 7-0. 20 points for Engler. She hit her first three three-pointers to give her 8 in a row. Ended up 4 of 6 from the field. 15 for Double D, Denise Daniels. 13 for Jasmine Stone. Just 1 for Harrison. McClendon, 7 points, 11 rebounds. 7-11. You'll take that anytime. 2 points each for Jablonski and Bistro. On the other side, Ellenberger had 17, but she had what, 11 or?
Had 11 of them in the first quarter.
Okay. Ended up with 17. Fields with a quiet 16 on 7 of 14 shooting. Whiting with a real quiet 10 points on just 3 of 9. Tucker with 9 points for Embry-Riddle. Rebounding ended up a plus 5 for the Rollins Stars.
And Robert, really, if you look at it, Embry-Riddle came in and the number one rebounding team in the league of rebounding margin. You talk about Rollins plus 5 on the boards. Offensive rebounds, Rollins plus 4, and that's something that Embry-Riddle really couldn't do. They couldn't hold the offensive rebounding for the Tars, and they were able to take advantage, and that's how Rollins ended up coming away with the victory.
So Rollins knocked off A really good top 20 team here today in a dogfight. And now we'll sit atop the conference at 3-0 as they head down to Barry on Saturday.
Yep, and taking a look around the conference. Yeah. Florida Tech up on Lynn, 71-58. John Rose, the company, looking for their second straight win.
How much time?
2:14 left to go in the fourth quarter. Final in the Bowman, Tampa beating St. Leo, 75-50. Barry rolling over Palm Beach Atlantic, 94-67. So Barry will have some momentum taking on the Tars on Saturday afternoon. And Eckerd knocks Florida Southern from the ranks of the undefeated in the league, 79-67.
So the only undefeated teams in league play will be the Rollins Tars and Nova, right?
Nova Southeastern, who has the bye this week. And if their teams can take care of business, you're looking at a potential showdown that first Saturday in January between Rollins and Nova Southeastern. Rollins with three more conference games before that one, starting with Saturday's matchup in Miami Shores.
Thank you very much, Victor. Outstanding job. We got to, by the way, we got to pick ourselves the Hilton Orlando in Altamont Springs Player of the Game on this, our Yogurtland post-game show. And not an easy task here. Yeah, Engler was great early, absolutely burying those threes to really get the Tars going. Ended up with 20 points in this one. Denise Daniels, who's really been on a hot streak, had 15. Jasmine Stone, she also closed out well by hitting those two free throws. So.
Yeah, I think Stone's going to get my player of the game,
there,
especially the way that she hit that three-pointer and ended the game with the free throws to give the Tars a two-possession lead. Ended up with the victory, and she looks so, and for someone who shoots only 42% from the free throw line, very calm, very confident stroke, hits the two big free throws, and maybe that can serve her well down the stretch with those free throw shooting.
Yeah, so Jasmine Stone from Evans, Georgia, and those last two free throws were absolutely clutch free throws for the senior from Evans, Georgia, and we want to send our best regards to Julia and Christopher up in Evans, Georgia. It was a pleasure meeting them the other day, and their daughter played exceptionally well here today. Thank you, Victor.
Thank you, Robert.
The Rollins Tars remain undefeated. We'll be back on the air in about 20 minutes with Gentleman Jim Farrow as the men will clash with Embry-Riddle. You're listening to Rollins College Basketball. The Tars 66, Embry-Riddle 60 from Winter Park, Florida. With Victor Anderson, I'm Robert Siegel. Stay with us for more basketball right here on the Tars Sports Network.